Hello everyone, welcome back. The topic for today is teeth selection from complete denture, that is prosthodontics. Now what are the objectives in selecting the teeth? So the first one is the teeth, it should be in harmony with the surrounding tissues. That means whenever you are selecting the teeth for the denture, then they should be in harmony with the surrounding tissue. That is, they are not creating any problems to the surrounding tissue, that can be a gingiva or mucosa. The next one is they should maintain the vertical dimension. Now we know we take various types of jaw relation. So vertical dimension is one of them. Now the teeth that you are selecting, so they should maintain that vertical dimension, because if the vertical dimension is more or less, then it will have like various ill effects. Now what are those ill effects? So I have covered in the video of vertical jaw relation. So you should see that whenever we are selecting the teeth, they should maintain the vertical dimension properly. The next one is they should be efficient for mastication. Now, why are the patients coming for the denture? Basically, it's for they want to eat. So, it's for mastication. So, whenever you are selecting the teeth, so the teeth, they should do the work of it. That is the mastication, that the person or the patient, they should be able to chew the food. The next is the posterior teeth, they should be selected based on the function. Whereas the anterior teeth, they are selected predominantly based on the aesthetic. Now, we know we have the anterior and the posterior teeth. So basically posterior teeth, what are they doing? They are doing the function of mastication, that is chewing the food. And anterior teeth, they are basically mainly like used for aesthetics. So whenever you're selecting the teeth, you have to see that the posterior teeth are doing the function and anterior teeth, they are doing the aesthetic work. So these are the various objectives in selecting the teeth. Now this is a complete overview of your teeth selection. So teeth selection is basically classified into two, that is anterior teeth selection and posterior teeth selection. Now anterior, as I said, the anterior, when you're selecting the anterior teeth, they are based on the aesthetic. So in this you have three factors, that is you're selecting the size of the anterior teeth, then you're seeing the form of the anterior teeth, and also you're seeing the color of the anterior teeth. Now why? Because it is mainly used for aesthetics. The next is the posterior teeth selection. So in posterior you're going to see for the size and for the form. Over here, posterior, they are doing mainly the function of mastication. So in this, the color of posterior teeth is not of that importance as it is for your anterior teeth. So now we are going to see each one of them in detail, because now this question is very commonly asked as a long answer question. So anterior teeth selection, they are primarily selected to satisfy the aesthetic requirement, whereas the posterior teeth, they are used for the masticatory functional requirement. So in this, both the anterior and the posterior teeth, they must function in harmony with, and they should be anatomically and physiologically compatible with the surrounding oral environment. So this is nothing but the objective in the teeth selection that we have already seen. So the three basic considerations when you're selecting the anterior teeth are, you're going to see the size of the teeth, then you're going to see the form of the teeth, and you're going to see the shade or the color of the teeth for your anterior teeth. So starting with the first consideration, that is the size of the anterior teeth. Now in this, the teeth size, it should be appropriate to the size of the face and the gender of the patient. Now anterior teeth is mainly doing the aesthetic work. So in this, now whenever you're selecting the size of the anterior teeth, so it should be appropriate to the size of the face. That means if, now for example, if the size of the face is too small and you're selecting the anterior teeth too large, so obviously it will hamper the aesthetic. So whenever you are selecting the size of the anterior teeth, so it should be appropriate to the size of the face and the gender of the patient. So now which are the following methods which are used to see the size of the anterior teeth? So first one is methods using the pre-extraction record. The next one is the methods using the anthropological measurements of the patient. Third one is the methods using the anatomical landmarks. Fourth one is the methods using the theoretical concepts, and fifth one are the other factors. So first we are going to see about this pre-extraction records. So which are the methods using the pre-extraction record? Now as the name says, you are like saving something and you're using the size of the tooth which the patient was having before the extraction, and then you're going to just cross-check it, and then you're going to place the same artificial teeth size in that patient. So first can be the diagnostic cast. So over here, diagnostic cast are the ones which is taken before the extraction. Now over here you can see, so this are the diagnostic cast in which the patient, they are having their natural teeth. So now it becomes very easy, like you're directly measuring the size of the teeth and then you're going to place the same size of the teeth to the patient. So they are prepared before the extraction. Now these are the methods which are used pre-extraction. So All these methods, they are prepared before the extraction of the teeth. Now in this, the actual size and the shape, it can be determined. But now in this, the shade of the teeth cannot be determined because now this is a cast. So you can see the size and the shape, but the shade you cannot see. So this is the first method. The next one is the pre-extraction photographs. So in this, you are taking the various angulation photographs of the patient and then you have to use that for your like teeth selection. So in this, the photographs which is showing the anterior, lateral and anterolateral views of the patient, they should be taken before the extraction. And this method, it is useful to determine the exact width and the outline of the teeth. So this is the next method in the pre-extraction record. Third one is the pre-extraction radiograph. So now if you are taking the radiographs, so now again you can easily measure the size of the teeth and then you're going to select the same size of the teeth for your anterior teeth. Now in this, the occlusogingival height and the outline of the teeth, it can be recorded, but in this, the contour and the size, it cannot be accurately determined. So this is the drawback for your pre-extraction like radiographs. The next one is the teeth of the close relative. Now in this method, size and the contour of the patient's like son or daughter's teeth is taken as reference. When you see the other three methods, they are like not available. So in that case, you can consider this fourth one, that is the teeth of the close relative. And fifth one is the preserved extracted teeth. So whenever you are extracting the teeth, so if you are preserving it, so that can be used for the like selection of your anterior teeth, the size of it. So this is the best method to determine the size of the anterior teeth. But now you can see over here, so these are the various methods which are used before the extraction. But now all the scenarios, they are not like practically possible in every patient. So this is not very commonly used, but yes, it can be used in determining the size of your anterior teeth. The next are the methods using the anthropological measurements of the patient. So over here, anthropological is nothing but certain authors, they have done studies from ancestors and they have came out with certain formulas. So over here, this is nothing but the anthropological measurements, that you are doing some measurements and then you're going to substitute all those measurements that you have done in that formula and then you'll get whatever the size of the anterior teeth is. So in this, the first one is the anthropometric cephalic index and this is given by Shears. Now in this, what you do is you measure the circumference of the head with the help of a measuring tape at the level of forehead. So basically this is how you do it. You're going to place the measuring head over the surface of your forehead and you're going to just measure it and then you're going to substitute it in this formula. So the width of your upper central incisor. Now upper central incisor, so if you want to see the width of your central incisor, that is your 1-1 and 2-1. So in this, now you have seen the, or you have taken the measurement for your circumference of the head. So you're going to write it over here and it is divided by 13, and by that you will get the width of your upper central incisor. Now the next will be, if you want to see the width of your all upper anterior, that is your central incisor, lateral incisor and canine of both the side. So in that you'll see, or you'll like have this formula, that is bizygomatic width upon 3.36. So bizygomatic width is nothing but the width from one zygoma to the other zygoma. So this is the measurement that you do per year in the numerator, and then you're going to substitute the value whatever you get over here, and then you're going to divide it by 3.36. By this you will get the total width of your upper anterior teeth. And the next one will be, if you want to see the total width of the lower anterior. Now we know the upper anterior teeth, they are larger than your lower anterior. So for the lower anterior, it will be 4 upon 5 into width of your upper anterior. Now you have got the value for your upper anterior. So you're just going to substitute it over here. And then by that, you'll get this total width of your lower anterior. So this is the first method of your anthropological measurement. The one more method for your anthropological measurement will be, you're going to see the width of the nose, and depending on that, you're going to select the size of your anterior teeth. The third one is the Berry's biometric index. Now in this, you're going to see the width of your upper central incisor. So there are two like formulas which was given by this Berry's biometric index. So it will be bizygomatic width upon 60, or it can be length of the face upon 20. So bizygomatic is, as I said, you're going to measure the distance from one zygoma to other zygoma. By this you will get this first numerator and then you can just like substitute it over here and then you're going to divide it by 16. One more will be, when you see the face, length of the face, you're just going to measure the length of the face, then you're going to substitute over here and it is divided by 20. So this one is the Berry's biometric index. There's one more like method of your anthropological measurement that was given by H. Pound's formula. So in this, again, you're going to see the width of the upper central incisor and the length of the upper central incisor. Now in this it will be width and the length. So width will be like the horizontal measurement that you do, and length is the vertical measurement. So it will be the same as for your this Berry's biometric, that is bizygomatic width upon 60, and over here the length will be length of the face upon 16. So this is how the various anthropological measurements are to see the size of your anterior teeth. The next method are the methods using the anatomical landmarks. So now you have taken your impression and you have your cast. So that becomes the methods using the anatomical landmarks, that you're taking the measurement from the anatomical landmarks. So first can be the size of the maxillary arch. So in this, what you're doing is you're going to take the distance between the incisive papilla and the habilar notch on one side. So this is like how you're taking this distance. So over here, you're going to place the ruler on this incisive papilla, and then you just measure over here till the habilar notch on one side. And then what you're going to do is you're going to add the distance between the two habilar notches. So in this, it gives the combined width of both the anterior and the posterior teeth of the maxillary arch. So this is one of the method using the anatomical landmarks. So in this, the landmarks are your incisive papilla and the habilar notches. So by this, you'll get the size of your anterior, as well as in this method, you'll get the posterior size like of the teeth also. The next one is the location of the canine eminence. So it is the distance between the two canine eminence, and it is measured along the residual ridge, and it gives the width of the anterior teeth. Now, this one is the most commonly used one that we usually use in the colleges, that we just measure over here like this. We keep a thread from the canine eminence, from one canine eminence to the other canine eminence. And then what we just do is we are going to place that length of the thread on your set of teeth, and you're just going to see like where exactly the canines it goes to. So this is the next method that you're going to see the canine eminence. Through the canine eminence, you're going to select the size of your like anterior teeth. The next one is the location of the buccal frenal attachment. So in this, the distance between the two marking buccal frenum, it should be recorded and gives the combined width of the maxillary anteriors. Now over here, you're going to take the measurement from your both side buccal frenal attachment. The next can be the location of the corner of the mouth. So in this, what you're going to see is the canines and the corner of the mouth, they coincide at rest. So while smiling, the corner of the mouth, they are pulled away from the anterior teeth. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to like measure the distance from the corner of the mouth. The next one can be the location of the ala of the nose. So over here, the ala of the nose, it can be used to determine the size of the maxillary anterior teeth. So you're just going to see the distance between your ala of the nose, between like on the both side, and then you're going to just select the size of your anterior teeth. So these are the methods using the anatomical landmarks. The next are the methods using the theoretical concepts. So over here, these are the various theoretical concepts which were given by certain authors, and depending on that, you're going to see the size of the anterior teeth. But now this like theoretical concepts, they are not commonly used, but yes, if you get a question, then you need to like include this theoretical concept in your answer too. So the first one is the Winkler's concept. So in this, according to Winkler, the teeth, they should be selected based on three different view. So those are the physiological, the next one is the psychological, and the third one is the biomechanical. So physiological, it means that the facial musculature, it contributes to the aesthetic of the patient. Now, for example, if you are like increasing the thickness of the denture base in the labial and the buccal sulcus, so obviously it will produce that puffy appearance, because now what you're doing is you're increasing the thickness of your denture base. Because of that, the like patient, they will have that thickness on their face, that is the puffy appearance. So because of that, now if your denture is like fabricated properly, so it will give good aesthetic to the patient. But if you are like doing some errors in your denture base or the fabrication of your denture, then obviously it will show on the patient's aesthetic. So that is nothing but the physiological. The next consideration is the facial wrinkles, they fade when the vertical dimension is increased. So this is about the first view, that was your physiological. The next one is the psychological. Now in this, the camphor line is the psychological plane of orientation. Now over here, this is the camphor line. So if the camphor line, it is raised, so basically this camphor line, it is raised in happy people. So if the people, they are happy, so it will raise in those people, and if the people they are depressed, so this camphor line it will be like tilted in such patients. So that becomes the psychological view in the Winkler's concept. And the third one is the biomechanical. Now in this, the teeth, they should be set in the neutral zone. So this is about the Winkler's concept, which is a theoretical concept. The next one is the tidal form theory, and this theory it was given by Leon Williams in 1917. So according to this theory, the shape of the teeth, it should be inverse of the shape of the face. So according to this theory, what he said was, so Leon Williams, he said that whatever the shape of the face is, so when you're selecting your anterior teeth, so the size or the form of your anterior teeth, it should be inverse of your shape of the face. So this is the next theoretical concept. The next one is the concept which was given by J.W. White, and that is the concept of harmony in 1872. So according to J.W. White, the size and the color of the teeth, it should be in harmony with the size of the head and the color of the eye. So he said that the size and the color of the teeth, it should be in harmony with your size of your head and the color of the eye. So these are the various methods using the theoretical concepts. Now the other factors of your size of the anterior teeth will be, you're going to see the size of the face. Depending on that, you're going to select your size of your anterior teeth. One more can be, you're going to see the inter-arch like spacing, and depending on that, you're going to select your anterior teeth. One more can be the size and the relation of the arches. Again, the next can be the length of the lips. So depending on the length of the lips, you're going to select the size of your anterior teeth. And one more, it can be when you're going to measure the distance between the distal end of your maxillary canines, and depending on that, you're going to select the size of your anterior teeth. So these are the various methods through which you can select or you can choose the proper size of your anterior teeth. So in this video, I have covered about the size of the anterior teeth. Now in the next part of the video, I'll cover about the form and the color of the anterior teeth, and even about the posterior teeth, like the posterior teeth selection. So this was all about this first part of your teeth selection and complete denture. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share, and do subscribe to my channel.